Welcome to part two of our tutorial on painting Thanquol and Boneripper. Now, so far we've painted the individual details of each characters, and in this part we're going to be painting all the large details that appear on both of them. So this will be things like the armour and the metallics, and also the tails too, which is what we're going to start with. So let's get to it. Back in part one, we did the base coats on both the tails. On Thanquol, it was ratskin flesh, and on Boneripper, it was Bugman's glow. And now we're going to carry on in the same way for the rest of the stages on the tails, starting out with blood letter, which is going to give them kind of like a pinkish tinge. And well, I'm using a large brush to apply this, as usual, put some of this onto your palette, so you can control how much is on your brush, and you want a fair amount loaded. And all you're going to do, I'll start out on Boneripper, all you're going to do is start painting this all over the tail. So an even coat, you don't want so much that it's dripping off the model, so an even coat like I'm doing here, then give it plenty of time to dry. The glaze has taken about 10 minutes to dry, and now that that's done, we can start adding a highlight to the tail. Now the colour I'm going to be using now is Cadian Fleshtone, and I'm going to be applying it using my fine detail brush. So you just need to make sure you use your palette here to get a really good tip on the brush, because you need as much control as possible. So thin down with a little bit of water, a bit more than that, I think. Yeah, that's about right. So get a good tip on your brush. And what you're looking to do is paint a highlight along each of the ridges on the tail. So if I start on Boneripper again, I'm going to be starting just towards the bottom of each of these areas here, and just painting a line running along it like that, close to the little dip in the tail. So you see, just going to repeat this all the way down the tail. Now if I encounter any details like this cut along here, I'm also going to go around the edge of that to highlight it, just like that. And you need to repeat this on Thanquol as well. And with that highlight applied, the tails are now complete, and we can really start to add some colour to the miniature now, in the form of doing the blue armour. Now for this, the first colour that you need is staggered on scale green, which I'm going to be applying mostly using my large brush, but I've also got standard brush, and I might even need a detail brush as well, because there's quite a lot of this armour, and it really does vary in size. So thin the paint down as usual, make sure there's not too much on the brush, and really what you've got to do is just start looking around the model for all the armour that you want to be blue, and just start base coating it with this colour. Now, as I say, there are quite a lot scattered around, and they appear on all the sub-assemblies that we've got, so I really recommend you check your box art just to guide you through which bits to do. Now that I've finished base coating all the armour panels, we can start to add a shade to it, and for this the colour I'm going to use is Agrax Earthshade, and I'm going to be applying it using a fine detail brush, and that's because I want to be very focused about where I'm applying this. So I'm just going to make sure I don't have too much on my brush. About that should be fine. And what I'm going to do is start painting this into all the recesses on all the panels. So if I start on this one here, for example, I'm going to start painting it into this little area around here in between where this panel is, because that's going to be a different colour later on. Like that, you see, and that gives a nice bit of shading. So I'm going to do this all around all these recesses, including all the spikes and all the rivets and things as well. If you wanted to, you could use a larger brush and apply this shade all over these blue places, but that'll give a duller, dirtier colour in the end, and well, you might want that for your Skaven, but I want to keep this blue quite strong. So with that shade now done, you can see we've added loads of depth to that blue armour, and there's just one more step to do on it to finish it, and that is to add a highlight. Now for this, the colour I'm going to use is Thunderhawk Blue, and the technique is called Edge Highlighting. And to do this, you need your fine detail brush, and when you're preparing your paint in your palette, just thin it down with a little bit more water than usual. Still not loads, just enough to help the paint flow smoothly. And then what you're looking to do is to paint a line of this running around the edges of all the armour panels, and Skaven are great for this because their armour is so pronounced. So if I start on the arm here, what I'm going to do is just use the side of my brush, just run along that edge there, and you can see this very quickly gives me a sharp and neat highlight running around the armour. So what you need to do now is do this around the edges of all the blue parts. You don't need to worry about the rivets or anything, just the edges of the panels. And with that highlight done, the blue is now complete, so we can move on to adding one of the other brighter colours on the model, and that's the red. Now for this you need three different colours. We're first of all going to do a base coat of corn red, then shade over these areas using Agrax Earthshade, and finally add a highlight of Evil Sun Scarlet. So starting out with the corn red, I've got two brushes to apply this base coat. I've got my large, which is what I'm using now, and also a standard, which I'll switch to for all the smaller areas. And well, you just need to thin your paint as usual on your palette. And then really you're just looking to base coat all the red areas with this colour. So I'm going to start out with Thanquol because there's quite a large area on him. But this red does appear all over the model, so be sure to check your box art. That will guide you through which bits to do. I've applied two coats of corn red, and now I've got a good solid colour ready for the next step, which is to apply a shade of Agrax Earthshade. I'm going to be doing this very slightly different on Thanquol from Boneripper. On Thanquol, I'm going to be applying this all over the red. And just a word of advice, just be careful on the inside of his coat that you don't get this on any of the other colours. And on Boneripper, I'm going to be much more focused to get the result of the red here being brighter than on Thanquol. So I'm using my fine detail brush to paint the Agraxer shade into all the creases and folds on the cloth, just like these little areas around here. And on the pipes and the collar, I'm instead going to be looking for the areas where the red will meet the metal. And when the shade's fully dry, add a highlight of Evil Sun Scarlet. Now, I'm using my fine detail brush for this, and I'm looking for all the edges and sharpest details on the red, such as on Thanquol here. On the pipes, however, there are no edges really to highlight, so in this case, just paint a line of Evil Sun Scarlet running down the top half or so of the pipe at an angle, so about 45 degrees from the top. And there we go, the red is now done. So the next detail that we're going to paint is the wood, and for this you only need two colours. First of all, we're going to do a base coat using Rhinox Hide, and then we're going to dry brush over that using Tyrant Skull. So starting out with the Rhinox Hide, I'm going to apply this base coat using my large brush, and well, there's just a couple of areas you're looking to paint with this colour. I'm going to be starting out by painting Thanquol's staff, so start base coating it up here. But on Boneripper, there's some details on his belt, they're kind of like triangular shields, and you just need to base coat those areas with the same colour. Then apply a very light dry brush of Tyrant's Skull over the wood. Now if you happen to apply it a little bit too heavily and the colour's too strong, a great way to knock it back again is to apply a shade of Agrax Earthshade all over the wood. And with the dry brush done, the wood is now complete and we can move on to painting a really distinctive feature of the model, and that's all the metallics. Now there's both silver and bronze on this model, and I'm going to be doing both of them mostly at the same time, but I'll start with the bronze, and for that the base colour you need is Balthazar Gold. Now this colour appears all over the model, so on all of the sub-assembly parts, and the size of these parts varies quite drastically. So I'm going to be using my large brush to begin with, but I've also got a standard and a fine detail brush as well. So just prepare my paint in the usual way with a little bit of water mixed in, make sure I don't have too much on my brush, and I'm going to start on Boneripper on one of these warp fire throwers up the top here. So for this first stage, you're just looking to base coat this colour as evenly as possible, and you might find you need to do two coats to get a good solid colour. Now, I recommend you follow the box art for this to get a good even spread of both the bronze and the silver later on. But of course, that's really up to you. I've finished applying the base coat of Balthazar Gold now on Boneripper and all the sub-assemblies, including Thanquol as well. And now we can start doing the silver. Now, the first colour for this is Lead Belcher. And this is applied in much the same way as we've just done with the Balthazar Gold. So I've got my same three brushes, starting out with the base coat of Lead Belcher, thinning it down with a little bit of water, not too much. And then, well, applying it on all the parts that you want to be silver. So I'm going to start up on this warp fire thrower once again, just base coating it around here. Now, as you're doing this, it's just about inevitable, really, that you'll get some of this silver on some of the bronze parts. I mean, I know I'm going to. If and when that happens, just make sure you neaten the bronze up again before you carry on, because it is important that you do that before we start the next stage. I finished applying the Lead Belcher now, and you can see with both metallics base coated, well, the model's had a massive difference made to it. The next step is to apply a shade to both metallics, so both the silver and the bronze. And for this, I'm going to be using Agrax Earthshade, okay, for both. So I'm still going to be using the same three brushes, starting out with my large one here, and you need to switch between your brushes as you need to, because you really do need to keep the shade under control for this, so that you don't get it onto the other colours. So I'm going to start once again with my warp fire thrower up here, and I'm just going to apply this shade over all of these metallics, just letting it run into the recesses. You can see I'm not putting on loads at once, so I keep control of it. And I'm being especially careful as well where it gets close to other colours, like the skin round here. I've finished applying the shade now and given it plenty of time to dry as well, and you can see it's really brought those metallics together and added some depth to them. And with that done, we can now start to highlight them. Now, I'm going to start out by highlighting the bronze, and the colour you need for this is Cycorax Bronze. And the method I'm going to use is an edge highlight. So, like when I was doing the armour, I'm just going to make sure I'm using my fine detail brush, and I'm thinning the paint down so it's running smoothly, and not too much on the brush, and I'm looking to paint this around all the sharpest edges on the bronze parts only. So if I start once again on this warp fire thrower up here, I'm going to use the edge of my brush and just run around the sharpest points like that, and see I get a nice fine highlight very, very quickly like that. Now also, I'm going to be doing all the rivets at the same time. So a lot of them appear on the metallic areas, but some are on the armour as well, on the blue armour. So you just need to paint a small amount of this, just on those little raised bumps. And with the edge highlight done on the bronze, all that remains is to do a highlight on the silver parts as well. Now for this I'm going to be using Runefang steel, and the application technique is going to be, well, the same edge highlighting technique that we just done. So still with my fine detail brush, thin the paint down just a little bit so it's nice and smooth. A bit more. There we go. And you're looking to paint this once again on all the sharpest edges of the silver parts this time. So if I start up here, once again, I'm just going to be painting it on these edges like here, just being careful of that skin and all the other colours as you get near them. Now also, there is the chainmail to do at this stage as well. And for this, all you have to do is just very gently run your brush down these areas, just like that, to let the paint just catch on the most raised parts of the chainmail, like that. And also what you can do, if you want to, on the bronze parts, is add another highlight of this Runefang steel, just on the very sharpest and most raised parts, such as on the edges of the guns, just like that. And this will just have the effect of making your bronze look especially shiny. And with that final highlight of Runefang steel now applied, all of the metallics are finished. And now we'll move on to painting the black areas. Now the black only actually appears on Boneripper, and to do it you just need two colours. First of all, we're going to base coat using Abaddon Black, and then add a highlight using Eshin Grey. So starting out with the Abaddon Black, I'm going to be applying this using my standard brush, and well, you're just looking for, once again, a nice even base coat of this. So you just need to get your paint ready. And well, the areas you're looking to apply this on are his belts. So there's one that goes around his waist, this quite large one round here. And also there's a couple others up around his shoulders which hold all the apparatus on his back, and also his shoulder pad as well. Then highlight the black using some Eshin Grey and your fine detail brush by just painting some lines running along the edges. Now remember, when you're doing this, just be really careful not to get this colour on the flesh. Now that we've finished painting the black, we can move on to the last part that I'm going to show you how to paint in this video, and that's these large pipes that connect to the warp fire throwers that are on his back. Now for this, the first colour that you need is Steel Legion Drab, and I'm going to be applying most of it using my large brush, but it's quite tricky to get some parts around his arms, so I do have a standard brush for those parts. So you just need to get your paint prepared in the usual way, just a little bit of water mixed in there to thin it down so we get a nice smooth finish to it. And all you need to do is start base coating this all over the pipes. So I'll begin on this one just here. Just need to work your way just up to the metal there, just like that. Now with this colour you'll find that you will need to apply a second coat after you've done the first one to get a nice solid colour. And with that second coat of Steel Legion Drab now applied, we've got a good smooth solid colour ready for the next step, which is to add a shade all over the pipes. Now for this I'm going back to Agrax Earthshade once again, and I'm using my large and standard brushes still. And well, just need to put an even coat of this colour all over the pipes. So starting out with my large brush, I'm just going to apply this, not so much that it's starting to drip off the pipes. You don't want the coat to be fairly thin like that. And remember to give this plenty of time to dry. Now when it is drying, just keep an eye on it to make sure it's not collecting too much towards the bottom of the pipes, in particular areas like here where it dips down. Once the first coat of Agrax Earthshade is dried, add a second one to certain sections of the pipe, and this will give the impression of all the different bits of the pipe being cobbled together from different sources. Now you could, if you want to, even add a third coat to some parts, and this will give you even more variety. And there you go, you can see that by varying the amount of shade we put on the pipes, we've got a nice bit of variation on them. And well, there's just one more thing to do on them, and that's to paint the stitches. Now for this you need Screaming Skull and your fine detail brush, and this is going to be, well, just like all the other stitches that we've done on the model so far, just like on Thanquol earlier on. You just need to get a small amount of Screaming Skull on your brush, and you're just looking to paint all the little raised detail of the stitches. So I'm going to start on this pipe here. You just need to be as neat as possible when you're doing these bits. And there we go, that's all the main details on Thanquol and Boneripper done, and well, they're looking almost finished already. All that's left to do are some finer details, and this will be things like the teeth, the claws and the warp stone, of course, and we'll do all those parts in part 3. So remember, when you're going through these stages of painting Thanquol and Boneripper, neatness really is the key. The neater you are, the better the final result's going to be, and there are a lot of fine details in all the areas of colour that we've done in this video, so just take your time with those parts and make sure you get them all. Also, remember with the shades, I applied them in moderation, and this was so I could keep control of them. It's very easy to lose control of shade and get it on areas of colour that you don't want it to be on. So now this part is finished and we're going to move on to part 3. And in part 3, we're going to complete the model. So I'll see you there.